Hey, this is Steve over at Skill of Strength, and today I'm going to show you guys another option as something else that you could potentially use instead of a wall sit. The wall sit is something that coaches use quite often as a regression from a squat, or when you're working with a large group of athletes, it can be a good starting point to introduce them to like squat-like movement. But I think it has its downfalls, and I think sometimes it's hard to transfer that wall sit into other things, even the bodyweight squat at times. This is another option. It's going to be called a hip hinge ISO. And we're going to use a wall as well, so this is kind of my fake wall here. We're going to set up with your feet against the wall and tell your athletes or for yourself, just take a step forward. Everyone's going to be a little bit different with where they should be, how far away they are from the wall. The farther away you are, the harder it's going to be. The closer you are, the easier. So you're going to have to find this happy medium with how far away we want to be. But in general, about your foot's distance or a little bit more is probably where we want to be living. Okay? I'm going to angle my toes out a little bit. Then I'm going to bend my knees, and I'm just going to reach my butt way backwards until I tap my butt to the wall. Okay? If we notice that this is very easy, take a big step forward. If it's very hard and we can't get there, keeping a neutral spine, then we're going to want to take a little step backwards. Okay, if we're about in the right area, we're just going to hold this position. So again, we bend the knees, reach the butt way backwards. I'm going to reach my hands way forward. And we're looking for a nice neutral spine position. Knees to be out tracking the pinky toes. Hands to be out in front of our body. And we're just going to hold this position instead. Okay, now we want to be careful that we're not just sitting back against the wall. We're not using the wall to hold ourselves up. We're just using it as a point of reference for where our hips should be. Okay, and again, now if this is easy, I can take a little step forward, and that's going to force me to hinge a little bit deeper. Okay, so I'm going to have to reach my butt back a little bit more, and I'm going to hold a deeper hinge. Okay, I've been using this a lot with our young athletes here at Skill of Strength. It's been working really well. For me, it's a bit easier and a little bit more versatile to take them from a hip hinge ISO to teach them the bottom position for a jump, the bottom position for a kettlebell swing. I like it as a transition into the deadlift. I tend to use that bottom position, that hip hinge position of the hip hinge ISO. If I can get them to hold that for like a minute for a couple sets, I'm pretty confident that then I can go take them into a deadlift and that they know the bottom position I'm looking for, or we're going over decelerating properly for like a squat jump, that we have this cemented position to go off. Okay, so give it a try, guys. I hope you like it. I just think it's another good option to the wall sit. Thanks, guys.